Hey everybody, it is bottling time, and this is one of my favorite times of the year. So what I'm doing here is I'm filling up the sink with some hot water because I've got to get these labels off. You don't necessarily have to take the labels off, but you definitely have to clean the inside bottles, and we'll go over that in a minute. I like my bottles clean. It's just kind of my style. So I've cleaned all these beforehand. I did some bottling earlier in the month, and I had some extras left over, so I don't have to tear those labels off. But I've got to get these soaking in the hot water, and I'll show you the process to get those labels off. You got to let them soak for a little bit, and then I use a wire pad, and they come off pretty easy. So stick around. I'll show you how to do it. Okay, once those bottles are full, just go ahead and let them soak for, I don't know, 10-15 minutes till the label starts peeling off pretty easy. Some of the glues that they use, like for instance this one, you can already see that it's starting to peel up. That one's going to be an easy one. There's been others before where I've let them soak for an hour and still there was residual glue left on the bottle, and when they're like that, I just toss them. I don't even mess with them. So yeah, once they're to that stage, I mean, geez, it doesn't get much easier than that. This front one, yeah, see? That's what you want to see right there. That's just too easy. Not all of them are like this, though. This is kind of an anomaly here. This one probably won't be as good. Yeah, okay, see, that's a little more typical. So what you've got to do there is I just get a side started, and then I just kind of work the label over like that until they come clean. And granted, there's still some glue on there, but I'll hit it with a wire pad and it'll take all that right off. Important thing is just let them soak for a little bit. That always helps. Let me show you the wire pad. It's just a Scotch-Brite copper pad. Nothing fancy about these, but they work great. So I just take that and I just scrub the outside. Until I can't see any more residual glue. And then they're done. Okay, once that label is off, sometimes the water heats up the glue so much that it gets tacky. And that's not really good for scrubbing because what it does is it just kind of bunches together and moves it around. So what I've found that works best is drain your water. You're going to want clean water anyway for the next batch of bottles. So dump out the hot water. Turn on the cold, And the cold basically makes the resin hard again. And you can actually scrub that off a lot easier. It just comes right off. But you've got to use the hot water in order to loosen up the glue. And then if it gets tacky like that, then you've got to go back to the cold. So just try that process and it should work fine. Now that the outside of the bottles are clean, what it's time to do is make sure that the inside of the bottles are clean. And I know that these bottles are fairly clean because after every bottle that I drink, I always rinse it 3 times. There's the rule of 3 again. So I'm not going to spend a ton of time cleaning the inside of these bottles. What I'm going to do is I'm going to dunk each one in hot water and break up anything that may be on the inside that have dried. After that, it's just a matter of cleaning them with a solution that I've made up here. And I use this same solution that I clean everything with that comes in contact with the wine. And it is 4 grams of potassium metabisulfite and 2 grams of citric acid per gallon. And that's strong enough to kill any kind of bacteria or any other kind of neutralize any other kind of cleaning agents that have come in contact with any of your equipment. So from there, I'm just going to let them dry and then we can bottle. So stick around. Okay, all my bottles are clean. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little funnel and I'm going to add my cleaning solution. I'm going to fill it up about 1/3. I'm going to stick my finger in the top. Shake it. Get that cleaning solution all over the inside of the bottle. And then I'm going to pour it into the next bottle. And I'll use that same solution for about 5 bottles, and then I'll dump it out and I'll pour in some new fresh solution from the gallon jug. And then from there, the rule of 3, we're going to rinse it 3 times. After the 3rd rinse, give it a smell. You shouldn't smell any sulfur, any citric acid, any residual wine, nothing. It should smell fresh and sweet. And then after that, dry it, it's good to go. You're ready to bottle. So I'm just gonna continue that through the rest of the bottles, and then we'll get into some bottling.